Vitamin C. What is vitamin C? Everybody talks about vitamin C. People talk about taking vitamin C when you have a cold. It's probably not going to help you much once you have the cold. But in this video, we'll talk about vitamin C, what it is, what it does do, what it doesn't do, and how you know whether you've got enough. So welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. And I've had my issues with vitamin C, and I will tell you a few little stories about that. So vitamin C is ascorbic acid, sometimes just known as ascorbate, doesn't matter. Those are for the chemistry geeks. Vitamin C is a water-soluble vitamin found in citrus fruits, and I bet you knew that. If you are on a low-sugar diet and you're not eating fruit, you will still get your vitamin C from vegetables. Most vegetables have vitamin C in them, broccoli, onions. And even if you're on a carnivore diet, you can still get your vitamin C if you eat a lot of seafood and organ meats like liver. But of course, you can just take a vitamin C supplement. Why do you need vitamin C? You need it for a number of things. One is it helps you absorb iron from your food, which you need in your blood. And I'm going to tell you a little story about that in a second. It is very important for the construction of collagen, which means repair of cartilage, repair of bones, building blood vessels, repair of muscles, very important. And it is a vital part of your immune system. It's an antioxidant, and it makes your immune system stronger, which is why people think you can take vitamin C tablets when you have a cold. The link between vitamin C and colds is down to the immune system, and if you have consistently adequate vitamin C intake, your immune system will be strong and you will be better placed to fight off the colds and the flu. If you are low in vitamin C and you get sick, it's pretty much too late. You are going to suffer more from the cold. So you need to keep your vitamin C levels up all the time so that when you get a cold, you can fight it off a little bit better. Okay, how much are we supposed to take? Well, the recommended daily allowance of vitamin C is different from country to country, which immediately makes the whole thing a bit weird, because you would think by now that international scientists would agree. And it can be anywhere between 40 to 110 milligrams of vitamin C a day. That will depend what you've got in your food, because if you're eating enough vitamin C in your food, you don't need to supplement. If you are eating a lot of sugar, you're on a high sugar diet, you actually need more vitamin C, because sugar and vitamin C compete with each other to get into your cells. So if you are on a ketogenic diet or a carnivore diet or a paleo, Atkins, low sugar, whatever diet, you don't need as much. But you can take up to 2,000 milligrams a day if you want to. And so typically, supplements are 500 milligrams, 1,000 milligrams. Now, your body will take what it needs. The rest will stay in your gut and work its way through. But if you have too much, you will have an upset stomach. Okay, I made this mistake. I was due to compete in a race. It was actually the World Championships duathlon. And the night before, I went down with a cold. And I was one of the favorites to win the title, and I got a cold, and in a panic, I found a pharmacy and I bought some vitamin C, and I took 15,000 milligrams. Trust me, I spent the entire night sitting on the toilet, and I did not win a world title the next day. So too much vitamin C will just give an upset stomach, but that's not the end of the world. How do you know if you're short of vitamin C? Well, one of the obvious symptoms, and the most obvious symptoms, is bleeding gums. If you're brushing your teeth and when you spit the toothpaste out, it's pink, there is a strong chance that you are a bit low in vitamin C. But there's another funny thing that can happen. And here, this here, is a blood test that I had done recently. And I was really doing it just to look at all my cholesterol and triglyceride levels, because I eat a lot of fat and I don't eat any sugar. And they were fine, which is what I expected. But I noticed I had a couple of strange readings around red blood cells and iron levels. And my red blood cell count was low. My reticulocyte count was high. And those are new blood cells that are very young and not fully formed, and they've been released too early from the bone. Yes, your blood cells are made in your bones. And your bones are, my bones were releasing very immature blood cells into my bloodstream in a desperate attempt to get the red blood cell count up. So I had low red blood cell, and this all spoke to anemia, which is an iron deficiency. And one of the symptoms of anemia is fatigue. And I was very tired in the afternoons. I was sleeping every afternoon. But I shouldn't have been low in iron because I eat a lot of meat. So how can I be anemic if I'm eating lots of red meat? But of course, the iron in your blood does not just depend on the iron that you eat. It depends on the iron that you absorb into your blood from the food you eat. And the key to that is vitamin C. So instead of taking an iron supplement for my anemia, I took a vitamin C supplement, and within 2 days I was fixed. I wasn't tired, I wasn't sleeping in the afternoon. So vitamin C, very important for iron uptake, for collagen formation, to repair of joints, muscles, blood vessels, bones. It's good for your immune system, but you have to keep it up on a regular basis. It's a very good antioxidant, which helps you recover quickly from colds. You get it from citrus fruit. If you're on a low sugar diet, you can get it from your vegetables. If you're on a carnivore diet, you can get it from seafood and liver, or you can take a supplement. You will need more if you eat a lot of sugar. So 500 milligrams or even 1,000 milligrams supplement is actually fine, because you need to go probably over 2,000 or 3,000 if you really want to have an upset stomach, but you don't want to do that. Trust me, I've tried. That is no fun. Right, there you go. There's the lowdown on vitamin C. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your time. Please subscribe to our channel, and so that you don't miss any of our new videos.